Well, next on the programme is a piece which celebrates music itself. We are the music makers and we are the dreamers of dreams. These are the evocative opening lines of Edward Elgar's romantic choral piece, The Music Makers. They come from a collection of songs and poems called Music and Moonlight by the poet Arthur O'Shaughnessy. Elgar set them to music for the Birmingham Festival in 1912. The Music Makers is full of quotations from Elgar's earlier works, including The Dream of Gerontius, Sea Pictures, and The Enigma Variations. It's like a mini autobiography of Elgar, reflecting events and feelings from various periods of his life. Joining the BBC Symphony Orchestra are the BBC Symphony Chorus and the mezzo-soprano Lorraine Hunt Lieberson, who plays an important role in the piece.
I think Elgar felt that very deeply, a sense of a mission and in this poem it says of renewing our world as of yore. But I don't think we're just talking about music makers, of musicians, I think it's all artists, and I think, you know, all human beings should be included in that, because we are all creators in some way.
Elgar's mastery of the large orchestra was second to none. The work is full of his spectacular orchestral effects. And here now, leading the way, is the American mezzo-soprano Lorraine Hunt Lieberson. Behind her, the conductor, Leonard Slatkin, to join the massive forces on the stage of the BBC Symphony Orchestra and Chorus for Elgar's The Music Makers, live here in the Royal Albert Hall on this opening night of the proms.
Thank you.
the music makers, and we are the dreamers of dreams. The first and the last words of the music makers by Edward Elgar, performed here on the first night of the proms by the American mezzo-soprano Lorraine Hunt-Leverson, the BBC Symphony Chorus and Orchestra, with its leader Michael Davis and its chief conductor Leonard Slatkin. Such rich, romantic, highly personal music. What attracted Elgar to O'Shaughnessy's poem, he says, was the concept of the artist as the dreamer, alone at the water's edge, apart from the world, and yet inspiring every generation. Ravishing part not only for mezzo but also for choir, and the chorus is celebrating its 75th anniversary this season, making it older than the BBC Symphony Orchestra itself. And they'll be taking part in a total of 6 proms this year. It even has its own late night prom this season on the 21st of August. But here now back on stage, Lorraine Hunt-Leverson. She began her career as a viola player before turning to singing. And she's a performer of such intensity and magnetism. Works with all the great conductors and directors, born in San Francisco. And that huge cheer for the BBC Symphony Chorus, one of the busiest choirs around, has a long and fruitful relationship with BBC Symphony Orchestra, makes more television and radio appearances than just about any other choir, and has a huge range of repertoire. Chorus director of the BBC Symphony Chorus is Stephen Jackson.